What's up, guys? Dan here again, and today I'm bringing you something pretty interesting. You know, I went to TJ Maxx hoping to find that diamond in the rough, and boy did I find it. At least I think I found it. Now, it never meant to be that way at first. The reason why I bought this cologne, which I bought Realm, created back in 1993 by Erox. And the reason why I bought this is because I thought it would just make a funny video. Because on the box, you know, it says, contains human pheromones. And I thought, this has got to be a great story. I'm going to do some research on this and look it up and find out all about it. I thought, you know, it's going to be a stink bomb. It's going to just be something that sucks. Because I actually got up to my car, you know, excited and opened it up and sprayed it on a piece of paper. And it didn't really smell that good. So I wasn't really looking forward to wearing it to work and doing the whole experiment thing with it. But you know what? I put it on before I went to work that first time, and I was like, what the heck? What the heck? Is this the same stuff? I mean, I kind of liked it. And the more that I've worn this, I kind of really like it. And now that I've really done research on this, I kind of know why. It's got the juniper in it, and I have found out that I love the juniper. Now this scent, I'm going to do the rundown of the notes. Of course, it's got the human pheromone. It's got lavender, orange, patchouli, juniper, and ginger. For me, what I get out of this is I get the creamy lavender with a hint of the juniper, and it just mixes well. It's really soft and sensual, and it almost has got, it's almost reminiscent of vanilla. That's what it kind of smells like to me. And I was wearing it at work, and it kind of popped into my head, Lamal. You know, it's kind of reminds me of that. And so I got home and I did the test. And it kind of is in the same family, where Lamal seems a little bit more sharper and vibrant and brass. This is more subtle and smooth and creamy and soft. But I don't mean that in the projection way at all, because this thing is a projection monster. And the longevity is awesome. I mean, 8 hours, it was almost solid the whole time, and it just got a little bit soft. It's pretty linear though, which is cool because I love the way it smells right off the top. It just gets a little softer, you know, 4 to 6 hours later, but it still pretty much smells the same. This one for $10, I got it for $9.99, is unbelievable. You know, if you get a chance and you're at a discount place and you see Realm for $10, I recommend checking it out because it is definitely not bad at all. Now, as far as the human pheromone thing, I did a little checking into that, and you know, there's back and forth if it works, if it doesn't work, you know. But actually, it seems to be that there's a lot more articles out there that say that it actually does work. You know, the human pheromone is supposed to attract the opposite sex in a sexual way. And, you know, if it does actually do that, I don't know. But if it does, it's not like a magic wand, you know, to make somebody jump into bed with you. It's just supposed to be like a tool to help you get there. You know, just something to help a guy out in the battle. But, you know, it's actually a really great scent. And as far as the people at work go, I had one lady, she asked me if I wanted to go in the closet with her. She thought it smelled so good. That was funny. Thanks, Julie. And another girl said that it kind of smells girly, I guess maybe because the lavender and the berries. I don't know. It seems pretty manly to me. Another girl said that it smells like a cologne that somebody would wear to cover up a bad smell. And another girl said that it's more like an everyday scent To her, it smells like not something that you would wear on special occasions. But I did, overall, I did get a lot of positive compliments on this one, which was great. I mean, for what I thought it was going to be, I thought I had another gray flannel waiting to kill me, you know, and it turned out to be just a diamond in the rough. Just actually a pretty nice scent. And I guess that about wraps it up for the human pheromone. Now let's see what my lady thinks about this one. Hey, babe.
When Dan put it on for the first time, it still is, because I'm not feeling all that way. Feeling all that good with it. And I don't know, maybe it is because the human pheromones are like right on top. But I know when he brought it in for the first time, he says, try it, smell it. And I'm like, a little headache just brought in. I got in my vulnerable stage and I was like, oh, Dan, I don't feel good. I've got a headache and all that stuff. So this one, Mark, would be a panty dropper on this one because I would be so vulnerable. I'd be knocked out and someone probably would take my panties off. So, but I really don't like this one. It doesn't work for me. But if Dan likes it, it's all good. And if he tries, ask everybody else to try it, go ahead. Because it is, it's almost like the passion parties, and the girls know what I'm talking about.
No problem.
Like the passion party where you try the human pheromone oil on your skin and then it kind of reacts to your own body scent and stuff. So you'd have to try that one. It's almost probably like the male's version of that. So that's what I would say.
Yes.
All right, thanks, babe. I may not be a winner for her, but I think it's a gorgeous scent. And, you know, it's one worth checking out. $10, you can't go wrong. I give it probably, I don't know, probably a 7 or an 8 out of 10, for real. I think. I'm pretty sure. It's pretty good, though. But anyways, you guys, thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.